I've always had, since I'm 7 years old, a notion that good things always happen to me. And that I've seen in my long life that that's been true. Another thing is that I have found that I have to feel good in my body. I'm an athlete, I've been an athlete, I love sports, I love nature, it's important for me to feel good in my body. Now, at 13, my vision deteriorated, and I developed macular degeneration, which is very unusual for a young person to have that problem. But somehow, because I assumed that I felt that things would work out for me and that I felt good in my body, I seemed to go on doing things that maybe even normally sighted people didn't do. I mean, I even drove a car, if you can imagine, and never had an accident. And I just believed that that was the way of being, that I had this problem, and that's where I was until Abraham came into my life and made me realize that there's a possibility that I would be able to see again. And at a very, very deep level, I believe that I will one day see. I see myself as seeing, and even though I just turned 85 yesterday, there's as much to the rest of my life than I have already experienced. There is much in the future when I receive my normal vision back as I've experienced in my past, in the past 85 years. So the last tape that you has helped me on my journey, and that was the dominant thought. That was very, very helpful and has brought me to, well, I wanted to come here. It was the closest to Canada and it was just possible to come. This was my birthday gift to myself and my daughter. And here I am. So my question is, with this virtual reality, I normally think of all the magnificent things that I have experienced, and the magnificent sights and so on. And I do that often, not in this context, but I think about those lovely things. What is it that I can do that I haven't done that is going to bring me to my wish? My dominant wish is to reclaim my
vision. This will be easy for you. As we visit here, you'll feel some things begin to unfold within you. So just relax and we'll just visit back and forth. We want to ask you some things. When you think about your life that you have been living and are living, would you say that your dominant vibration is one of joy and anticipation, or one of...
I don't have to go any farther.
Let us say the word anyway. Concern and deprivation.
No, it's just pure joy and excitement.
We agree with that. We can feel that within your vibration. When we say, when you think about your life in general, does it feel like a life that has been wonderful or a life of deprivation? You say wonderful, and there's no question about that in your vibration. Now, when you think about the subject of your physical body, does it feel like one of well-being or not well-being?
Very well-being.
It is, isn't it? It feels like a body of well-being. When you think about the subject of worthwhile living of life, would you say you feel successful or unsuccessful?
Very successful.
No question about it. When you think about the subject of vision, would you say you've seen all that you would like to see, or you would like to see more?
I've seen a lot, but I'd like to see
that's
more.
Where the vibration, that's where the vibration dips, isn't it? In other words,
right.
Everything more general in nature, you feel very good about. Now, always when people are acknowledging the creative unfolding of others' lives, when someone sees someone who cannot see in the way that they can see, most people would announce unequivocally, there would be no variation in their vibration. They really prefer to be fully sighted than to not have full vision. Almost everyone would say that. And yet, from broader perspective, from the standpoint of understanding life and understanding energy, your inner being would not necessarily say that. In other words, your inner being understands that life is about more things than just what you're translating through your vision, as you have very accurately acknowledged here, as you think about your wonderful life. You've come forth as a teacher to help many understand that you have not all come to evaluate and see life in exactly the same way, that sometimes a different vantage point is a value. You have the absolute right and absolute ability from wherever you stand to make your statements of desire. In other words, we're not suggesting for a moment that you have to say, well, sometime or other, without knowing it consciously or unconsciously, I've chosen this situation and therefore I have to live with it. Or I vibrated in a place where I disallowed my full vision and that's just the way it is and now I have to live with it. What we are saying to you is that we think that the positive attitude that you have learned through life experience and picked up in the ways that you have, as you apply it specifically to this or any subject, it will serve you extremely well. You have launched a very clear desire, and you've articulated it very clearly here today. And there is no reason that you cannot practice a vibration that will then put you in the place of allowing a full accommodation of what you are asking for. So then the next question is, well, if this very positive woman who sees life in a very positive light for the most part has not been able to allow her sight to return, then what chance do any of us have? Because you are a very positive person, and we say, but you have not been an absolutely positive person relative to the subject of your vision. Because when you pick up the stick called your vision, which comes up on a really regular basis, you've been vibrating more in the absence of it than you have in the presence of it. And who wouldn't? In other words, when you can't see, you can't see, and you get used to not seeing, and you sort of approach life from this place of not seeing, and you hear others talking about things that they are seeing, and you want to see them. And so what we are suggesting to you is you have focalized in a stronger than usual way your desire to have vision. You don't have to talk about that anymore. In other words, life experience has got that well into place. And now what you're wanting to do is practice some virtual realities that let that in. And it is our belief that as you find yourself predominantly in this good-feeling place of allowing your well-being to be received in all ways that you desire, that in that way, too, it can come. And we think that you are an exceptional vibrational receiver. That's one of the real advantages of having one of your physical senses muted in some ways, is that other aspects of your being become more acute. So, as you are beholding us here, describe what you do see. Let your eyes see a little of it. In other words, look generally into the fog, into the direction of Esther. You can see her dark form mm-hmm. against the lighter wall. Mm-hmm. And now as you're looking at the form that is Esther, notice the energy that surrounds it. It will look to you like an increasing of the fog, but it will be lighter in color. Just look softly. You have, because of your inability to see, developed some tendencies to feel rather than to see a lot of things that is serving you very well. Yeah. And so, without even knowing it, you've developed a pattern of approaching or perceiving that is serving you really well. And it's an interesting thing. There is perhaps no subject more powerful to talk about vibration than asking you what you can see, because what you're looking at in the moment and your ability to see it is so acute that it's such a dominant feeling, you see. So then when we say, well, never mind what's happening in the moment, let's go to a virtual reality, So now we will say to you, where are you going to take us in your scene? Anywhere.
My virtual reality?
Yes. You're going to set the scene like a director of the movie. Where is it going to take place?
Well, I'm in the Isle of Capri.
And
I'm at the top of the hill with my husband, at the top of the aisle.
Yes.
And looking out onto the expanse.
Yes.
And there's a hydrofoil. Now,
yes.
This goes back 20.
And yet it's happening right now, yes?
It's absolutely,
yes.
Right in my mind's,
yes.
Eye.
Yes. And so, go on.
And I see the hydrofoil that's headed, and hydrofoils were new in that time.
Yes.
And it was a pretty exciting place. Now, I was able to see the color,
yes.
Of the water.
And it was what color?
It was blue. It,
yes.
Was magnificent.
Yes.
It was an exquisite day. I feel the sun on,
yes.
My body. And the smells and my connection with nature,
yes.
Is so acute. It's, I'm just exhilarated.
Fabulous.
With
scene
joy.
Is over. Scene is over. We're ending it all only because we want to make a very powerful point right here. That utilization of vision will allow the restoration of vision. While you're in the moment trying to see and not being able to, activates that vibration. And so, oh, this is so good, because all of you, whether you're talking about your vision or something else that you're living, what's happening right now is so in your face. So it's logical that this in-your-face thing would be a dominant vibration. And yet it's necessary that something else become the dominant vibration in order to allow something else. So our encouragement to all of you, and especially to you, is don't worry about what you are not seeing. Feel appreciation for, as you so easily do, for the life that you have lived and are living. Then go to your virtual reality and have the experiences. And for you, we would say, don't go there with an eye of seeing something. Go there with the eye, just like everybody else, with the eye of looking for something to feel good, looking for something to feel good, looking for something to feel good. And it is our absolute promise to you that your desire will be received. There is not a reason in the world for it not to be.
Thank you.
Just don't hit it head on. Don't go to your virtual reality to improve your vision. Go to your virtual reality for the reason we want everyone to go to virtual reality, to practice a vibration that allows. You see?
I got it.
And don't talk to others about it, because there are those who don't want you to get your hopes up about seeing, because they don't want you to get disappointed. And we want you to understand that it matters not what anybody else thinks about this.
I believe that.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, indeed. Well, that's as good as it gets.